Manuel, can I invite you? Manuel's working for Mars, as Peter introduced already. And he just came back from Ivory Coast. And I would like to ask him to share his experience there. And the floor is yours.
Thank you. All right, good morning. Like Frodo said, I work for Mars Chocolate in the United States. I work out of an office in New Jersey. I live in New York City. And I spent the last 4 weeks in Africa. And the reason that I'm here today is because when we were in Africa trying to work out a project, we actually worked with ACPO. ACPO gave us, you know, a lot of advice on how to use their technology, how to use their programs. And so I had the pleasure of using ACPO Flow, which I'll discuss in a little bit, for 2 weeks, well, 3 weeks during my stay in Africa. So I want to talk to you guys about it. So in Mars, we have this program called the Farmer First, right? And we have we're leading in the industry as far as cocoa sustainability. So what we realized is that, you know, not too long ago, that there is a 1 million ton gap of cocoa supply in 2020. That means that most of the, you know, largest chocolate manufacturers in the world will not have enough product in 2020 to be able to satisfy the demand of their customers. And so we also realized that, well, as leading in cocoa sustainability, Mars needs to do something about it, and we need to do it right. So so we all got together, not me, because I've only been working there for a year, but, you know, people in cocoa sustainability, they all got together and they said, well, what can we do about it? And a bunch of experts started giving advice, and they said, well, you need to increase the productivity of cocoa farmers, you need to help them lead better lives, you need to, you know, give education. All these ideas came up. And then we started thinking, well, if we're going to do all this, we're going to do it right, so we're going to certify these farmers, right? We don't just want them to produce more because we want to buy more. We want to empower them. We want to make them self-sufficient. And we conducted this study where essentially we realized that there's not really enough plantation terrain in the whole world to be able to satisfy this. What we really want to focus on is we want to keep the current amount of terrain that we use to produce cocoa, but we want to increase their productivity. So then when we really looked at it, we said, well, just send an email to the farmer, or tweet, or Facebook, call the farmer to buy fertilizer and put it in their plants, and then everything is going to be okay. But then we realized, well, you know, these farmers are really not used to, first of all, fertilizer. They don't know how to apply it. And also, they don't have money to be able to buy a bunch of fertilizer that they're going to use 4 or 5 months afterwards. So it's not going to work. So essentially the farmer lacks money to buy fertilizer, but they get a very high return on investment once that fertilizer is produced. And so instead of just buying the fertilizer, we said, well, we have to create a credit system where we want to teach the farmers how to borrow money, how to use the money that they borrowed for good use, you know, buying fertilizer to increase their production as opposed to spending it on something else. And then we want to teach them that once banks are installed or microfinancing is installed in their area, that they know the importance of borrowing and paying back and investing that money as opposed to spending it on cars or, you know, anything else. And that's actually a picture of one of the farmers that I visited during the last 2 weeks. And I would say about